Hello everyone, welcome to Vishesh Educational Videos. So in this video, I'm explaining about the professional software development. Professional software development means what are the standards you need to maintain while developing the software. We are going to discuss on what are the knowledge you need to have to develop the software. So we are going to discuss about those things now. So if you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to like and share the video with your friends. So let me begin the explanation of professional software development. So professional software development means what? It is a software engineering, right? Related to software engineering. Software engineering is intended to support professional software development. Now you can ask a question. What is a professional software development? And what is an individual programming? Individual programming means you are not writing a single programs and you are not developing the software. No. To develop the software, you need to follow some procedures, some steps, some standards, which are of high standards or which are of high quality, and you have to develop your software. It's not just a simple programming. To develop the software, it's not just a simple programming. You have to follow some professional approach, right? So it includes techniques that support program specification, design, evolution. Getting guys? So you have to follow these steps, you have to follow this process properly to get the correct software without any problems. So it's not just a simple programming task. The software development means you have to follow some steps, you have to follow the process. Very simple, right guys? Next. So as you all know, software is not just the program themselves, but also all associated documentation, configuration data also will be there. Getting guys? If I say a software, it is not just a program. Software along with the program, it contains documentation data, configuration data also. So what is the documentation? Documentation means, as I told you, it's a user manual. So once you develop the software, you have to develop the user manual also. Because the user wants to know about his software, that's why you need to develop the documentation also along with the software. Configuration data means you have to tell the user on which configuration, in which configuration you can use your software. For example, what will be the RAM? RAM may be 4GB RAM, 6GB RAM, and what will be the hard disk capacity? 500 terabytes or 1 terabyte, like that. So all those things should be there, right? All those things should be known to the user to operate your software correctly. Getting guys? And also, if I say a professionally developed software, it is often a set of programs. It is not a single program. If I say a software or a professionally developed software, if you are maintaining a standards means, it is not a single program. No, if I say software, it may be a set of several programs. Getting guys? And also I told you, for when I say software, I have to write separate programs for separate features. For example, consider banking application. In a banking application, consider we have three features: to create account, to delete account, and to create the customer. You can see there, for create the customer, I can write a separate program. For creating the account, I can write a separate program. For deleting the account, I can write a separate programs. Along with that, I can include some configuration files for that separate programs. Right? Configuration file means, what are the platform details? I can include platform details means, can I use this program in Windows operating system or Unix operating system? So what is the RAM configuration? So I can include those details also along with my programs, separate packages. So I can, if I have a packages, I can use that package to run my software properly. Package is set, is like a set of program and configuration files. So you can use that to run your software properly. And if I say a documentation and if I say a user manual, it is not only related to user related documents. No, system related documents will also be there in the manual. System related documentation means it describes the structure of the system. So that means what are the components of the system, what is the architecture of the system. Getting guys, along with the user documentation, it will be containing system documentation also, which explains the structure of the system also. And also it will tell how to use the system and what are the websites for the users to download the recent product information. All those steps will be there in the system documentation. Getting guys? So hope you are understanding. If you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section. So one more important thing. To develop the software professionally, to develop the software by maintaining some standards, you need to know some of the things related to the software. So if you know the answer for all these questions, what we are going to discuss now, if you know all the answers, so it will help you to understand the actual development process of your software engineering. If you know answers for all these questions, definitely it will help while developing the software. Getting guys? What are these questions? So first of all, while developing the software, you need to understand what is a software first. You know that software is a set of programs to do some particular task. So this is the first question. If you know what is a software, then you can understand and you can develop a software product. If you don't know what is actually software is, how can you develop a software product, right? That's why you have to know the answers for these questions, then you can easily proceed further. Next, what are the attributes of a good software? While developing a software, you should know what are the attributes of the good software. Good software means, it should work properly. For example, maintainability, maintainability, right? It should be reliable. All those things we discussed, right? So if you want to know more about what is a software, what are the good attributes of a good software, the link for all these videos in the description, you can go through it, please, right? So now, next, once you understood what is software, once you understood what is attributes of a good software, you should understand what is software engineering. So software engineering, as you all know, it is a discipline that is mainly related to develop the software. So you can go through the videos, right? What are the fundamental software engineering activities means, you know that. We discussed all these things. Video links are there in the description. So software verification, software development, software specification, software evolution, and also what is the difference between software engineering and computer science. Computer science focuses on theory, software engineering mainly focuses on developing and delivering the software. Getting guys? Next, what are the key challenges? I explained the key challenges, heterogeneity, right? So those key challenges, you have to know this, because when you develop the software, you have to know all these things, differences, challenges, attributes of good software, all those things. If you know all these things, definitely it will be easy, right? That's why. So what are the cost of software engineering? Yes, obviously it is very, very important. Cost, because when you are developing a software, cost plays a very important role. According to one survey, roughly 60% of the software costs are development, 40% are testing costs. So you can see here, majority of the cost is for developing the software, not for testing the software. Around 60% of the cost is for developing the software. Around 40% of the cost is for testing the software. See, you have to know all these things. Why? You can ask a question, sir, what it will help? For example, see, if you know, according to the survey, if you know 60% of cost is for development, you have to spend within that only. You have to spend 80% of the cost for software development. Definitely, it will be a problem for you. That's why you should know all these things. How much you have to spend for development, how much you have to spend for testing. Getting, guys? So next, what is the next question? What are the best software engineering techniques and methods? So far we discussed lots of techniques, right? So you can go through the techniques, right? The video is there in the description. Next, lastly, what is the difference between the web made to software engineering? Obviously, if I say software now, the software is not a standalone software anymore. If I say software, around 90% of the softwares are web related today, because today we have internet. Majority of the software what we are developing, they has to use the internet. That's why you have to, while developing the software, you should try to develop the software that supports the web also. Otherwise your software will become outdated. Getting guys, if you know answers for all these questions, obviously you can develop your software more professionally. Getting guys? So hope you understood the concepts. Suppose if you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section. Thank you for watching the video.